Today, I will show you how to automate TV Ambient Light and Hyperion from Home Assistant. I will create several automations that will turn on and off the Hyperion and the TV Ambient Light along with your TV. It will be a fun video, so stay tuned! Hello, Kirill Pejanskis here. With Hyperion software, Raspberry Pi, HDMI capture card and few meters of RGB LED strip, you can make a beautiful TV ambient light that will change colors in sync with your TV. I described the whole process in this video, and since then, many of you managed to make this work. I received multiple success stories as well as pictures and videos in my Discord server, which is pretty cool. I'm also a very happy user of Hyperion and TV ambient light, but I often forget to turn on or off the LED strip along with my TV. As end result, the LED strip is either working the whole night or they don't work at all. And when I manage to remember, I have to manually open the Hyperion dashboard to enable or disable the LED device. That made me think of how to make an automation. What if I add the Hyperion to Home Assistant and make the automation there? Surprisingly, I managed to do that. And now I'm about to show you how. But first, I have a quick question for you. 85% of the views that I'm getting are coming from people that are not subscribed to my channel, and only 15 are from subscribers. Let me know in which group you are in the comments. Now let's start the Home Assistant Hyperion integration. Go to Configuration, Integrations, Add Integration, and search for Hyperion. Click on the result and enter the host where Hyperion is installed, actually the IP, and click Submit. You can choose an area here and finally click Finish. To add the Hyperion switch to Home Assistant Lovelace, do the following. Click on the Hyperion integration and then on the device, and under Entity section, add to Lovelace. Choose a view here if you have more than one and add to Lovelace UI. If you go to Overview, you see the Hyperion switch represented by a bulb and you can turn it on and off, of course. We now have the Hyperion in Home Assistant and we can switch on and off the TV ambient light from the Home Assistant Lovelace. It is time to automate this. I am going to use several automations that will cover most of the possible options. The first option will work great if you have a media player like Apple TV, Chromecast and so on that is already added in Home Assistant. The automation will monitor the media player current state. If it is playing, it will start, and if it is off, it will stop the TV ambient light. Let's see this first and then we will talk about the second option. I have added this media player, which is actually an Apple TV, and if I go to the menu, I can see that it is in idle mode. Then I can go to Configuration, Automations, Add Automation. I'll skip this. As a name, I will type, in a matter of fact, I can type anything here. For example, start Hyperion when media player play. As trigger, I'll select state. As entity, I'll select my media player, the Apple TV. And when this media player status become playing with small letters, execute this action. Call service, light turn on, pick entity, and my entity will be my Hyperion switch. I will go up a bit and I'll click on the three dots menu, edit in YAML, and I'll delete these brackets and I'll paste the following line. Effect USB capture. That means start Hyperion and start USB capturing. I'll go back to the overview section of Home Assistant and currently my Hyperion is turned off and my media player is in idle state. If I start something, the state will change to playing and Hyperion switch will turn on along with the USB capture effect, exactly as I wanted. Great! And here is how to make an automation that will stop the TV ambient light when you stop using your media player. The next automation is pretty much the same. I'll go to Configuration, Automation, Add Automation, I'll again skip this. I'll name it somehow. The triggers will be several this time. Again state, but this time when my media player becomes off, and I'll add another trigger. Type state again. The entity will be the same, my living room media player. And the state that I'm interested in this time is idle. And one final trigger, again from type state, again with the same media player. This trigger will be activated when the state of the media player becomes paused. When the media player is in either of these three states, call this action, call service, a light turn off, and entity will be my Hyperion entity. Save, that's it, the automation should be complete now. Currently my media player is in playing state and my TV ambient light is turned on, and if I pause, my automation is activated and the Hyperion and the LED strips are turned off. Everything works just fine. The second method to automatically control the Hyperion TV ambient light will cover the case when you don't have a media player in Home Assistant, but you have any kind of smart TV. But not very smart TV is enough. As long as it has an IP in your local network, everything is fine. I will make an automation that will ping my TV every 30 seconds, and if there is a positive answer, it will automatically turn the Hyperion and the TV ambient light. That automation should work fine no matter what media player are you using and what is the source. Let's create a binary sensor for our TV as it is needed for the automation. I'll open the file editor add-on to edit my configuration.yaml file, and I'll paste the following lines inside. The binary sensor is using platform ping. The host is the IP of my TV. Name can be anything. Count 1 means ping only 1. And scan interval 30 means scan every 30 seconds. I'll save the changes and I'll restart my Home Assistant. When Home Assistant has started, I can add the binary sensor to my Lovelace. I'll add a card. And I'll select entity card. I'll delete this and I'll search for my LG TV binary sensor. It says connected because my LG TV is turned on at the moment. I can click on the card to see the detailed view. We have the binary ping sensor. Let's create an automation that will utilize this. The binary sensor is now disconnected because I turned off my TV. That is to better demonstrate you the automation that I'm about to create. I'll skip this again. I'll name my automation somehow, it doesn't matter. The trigger type will be state again, but this time the entity will be my binary sensor. And when this binary sensor becomes on, means the smart TV is turned on and answered the ping. Call this service, a light turn on. The entity will be my Hyperion entity. And I'll again edit in YAML to add the USB capture effect. I'll enter new data section here and underneath effect column USB capture. That's it, I'm ready. Save and I can test the automation. Time to see the end-to-end demo of Home Assistant and Hyperion integration plus ping automation. And it is ping with G. Not pink like the color. While we are talking about colors, now is the best time to turn this boring gray like button into a happy blue one. Just click on it and all is done. Now let's continue. I'll go to overview section of Home Assistant and currently my TV and my Hyperion are off. I will turn on my TV now and I'll increase the speed. 30 seconds have to pass because of my scan interval and it is working. Hyperion TV ambient light is turned on around 30 seconds after my TV starts, which is great. You can make a turn off automation exactly the same way using exactly the same binary sensor. If you face any difficulties, let me know in the comments. If you are interested in smart home and IoT, don't forget to subscribe to my channel as I am releasing such videos every Wednesday. If you are just entering into the smart home world, I also have a smart home getting started actionable guide that will save your money and time. To secure this channel existence, you can become one of my supporters. In the video description, you can see how exactly. Follow me on Twitter and join my Discord server. Stay safe and don't forget, home smart, but not hard. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next Wednesday.